cheapest access to God Almighty.
My home will no longer be cursed. My home will no longer be cursed. My children will not be cursed. My family will not be cursed. Because I'm teaching from the injection. I have been redeemed from the
curse. This week you will conquer.
Amen.
This week you will overcome.
Amen.
This week your basket of testimonies shall be full.
Amen.
Nothing will stand in your way this week.
Wherever you are going, you have an angel. Why do you need angel? To direct you, to protect you, to lead you. Scripture. He doesn't really think about it. He asks God, God, what do you want us to do this month? And since, I believe, 2010, he has been naming months. And let me tell you something. A few people have been catching it, and it has been working for them. And I want you to make up your mind that every word, declaration that is being declared by the servant in the house, the servant of God in the house, he will manifest in my life that month in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As this month is the month of days of heaven and earth, I want you to go home and declare it. In my finances, it will be like days of heaven and earth. In my home, it will be like days of heaven and earth. At my job, it will be like days of heaven and earth. If you dare to make that declaration, if you dare to make that confession, watch the Lord do it. Hallelujah. He will do it. He will do it. Your amen is not loud enough. He will do it. Hallelujah. We have all heard about heaven at one point or the other, and we have probably assumed that heaven is a far place in the sweet by and by. But today we want to read from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 11, 8 to 21, and see that heaven can actually come to earth. Therefore, you shall keep every commandment which I command you today, that you may be strong, and go in and possess the land which you cross over to possess, and that you may prolong your days in the land which the Lord swore to give your fathers, to them and their descendants, a land flowing with milk and honey. For the land which you go to possess is not like the land of Egypt from which you have come. It is not like that place of sin, Not like that place of penury, of diseases which you have come, where you sowed your seed and watered it by food as a vegetable garden. But the land which you cross over, that you are crossing over this month to possess, is a land of hills and valley, the one that drinks water from the rain of heaven, a land from which the Lord himself cares for. He cares for the land. It's not a land that he uses hired laborers to care for. It's a land that which your God cares for. The eyes of the Lord your God are always on that land. Hallelujah. From the beginning of the year to the very end. That means that even this one we are talking about does not end in August. Hallelujah. It follows you to September, October, November, December 2016, 2017, till the rest of your life in the name of Jesus. And it shall be that if, when you see an if, that means you want to draw ear A and ear B and listen. If you earnestly obey my commandments, which I command you today, to love the Lord your God and to serve him with all your heart and with all your soul. Then, after the if, I will give you the rain for your land in its season, the early rain and the latter rain, that you may gather in your grain, your new wine and your oil, and I will send grass in your fields for your livestock, that you may eat and be filled. Take heed to yourselves, lest your heart be deceived, and you turn aside and serve other gods and worship them. Lest the Lord's anger be aroused against you, and he shut up the heavens so that there be no rain, and the land yield no produce, and you perish quickly from the good land which the Lord is giving you. Therefore, you shall lay up these words of mine in your hearts and in your soul, and bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. You shall teach them to your children, speaking of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. Confession. Hallelujah. And you shall write them on the doorpost of your house and on your gates, that your days and the days of your children and your grandchildren and great-grandchildren may be multiplied in the land of which the Lord swore to your fathers to give them, like the days of heaven above the earth. Hallelujah. Somebody just clap for Jesus. Amen. If that's all we do today, I think we have received something. But let's move forward. Let's go to Matthew chapter 6, verse 10. Let me read from verse 9. This is Jesus Christ teaching the disciples how to pray. In this manner, therefore, pray, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So it is the desire of Jesus, of God, that we live in the days of heaven on earth. That our days shall be like that of heaven. Whatever is happening in heaven must be happening here on earth. But I said earlier that sometimes we believe that heaven is a far place. And it is we get there in the sweet by and by. The kingdom of heaven is real. The kingdom of heaven is provable. The kingdom of heaven is tangible. Hallelujah. It is not an imaginary place and not a place that we only go to when we die. You can actually enjoy heaven here on the earth. Actually, it is the desire of God that we enjoy it. We have a foretaste of heaven before we get there. Hallelujah. And I will prove that to you. The kingdom of heaven is within us. It is a state that we assume at new birth. Let's look at Luke chapter 17, verse 21. Luke 17, 21. Nor will they say, see here, this is Jesus Christ talking again, or see there, for indeed the kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is within us. We need to live it out. Just like the whole creation was in God before he spoke it out into existence. Do you know that when God was creating heaven and earth, it wasn't then that he thought about it. He had already had it in his mind. There was the image of heaven and of earth, of the creation in God. And then he spoke it out. Hallelujah. The same way that the kingdom of heaven has been put into us when we give our lives to Christ. And then what we need to do is to begin to live it out. Hallelujah. It is a lifestyle to be exhibited. Lifestyle of freedom and unhindered joy. Hallelujah. It is joy, it is peace, it is righteousness. The book of Romans chapter 14 verse 17. Romans chapter 14 verse 17 says, for the kingdom of God is not in eating and drinking, but it is righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. So if you are lacking righteousness, you are lacking peace and joy, then you need to begin to desire it because you are not in heaven yet at that point. Heaven on earth, days of heaven on earth. So if your joy is lacking, I speak to you this afternoon. Return joy to you in the name of Jesus. As from today, you will not only be hearing about stories of heaven, you will be experiencing it in the name of Jesus. In your homes, you will be experiencing it in the name of Jesus. At your places of employment, in your businesses, you will be experiencing it in the name of Jesus. At new birth, you are born into that kingdom. If you are not born again and you are here and under my voice, there is no way you can partake of this that we are talking about unless you give your life to Jesus. Hallelujah. And the only way you give your life to Jesus is just by confessing him. Lord, you are my Lord. Jesus, you are my Lord and my Savior. That's all it requires. I forget everything, my life, I lay it down to you. And I told you, I want to enjoy heaven on earth. The devil pushing me here and there, slapping me, making me feel good today, making me feel bad tomorrow is enough. I want to experience perpetual joy. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Jesus came to demonstrate the kingdom of heaven on the earth. In the book of Luke chapter 7, verses 22 to 28. Luke chapter 7, verses 22 to 28. Jesus answered and said to them, we were talking about it in the class this morning, in the Bible class this morning, that John the Baptist, he was the one that called the people to let them know that Jesus Christ was coming. And when he was put in the prison, he expected his cousin, Jesus, to come and see him. He expected him to send somebody to him and say, oh, it's all right, brother, it's okay. I'm still walking around, but I will talk to you later. But Jesus did not show up. So he sent his disciples to Jesus. What is it that is going on with you? Are you the one that is coming, or should we be expecting somebody else? And Jesus answered and said to them, go and tell John the things that you have seen and heard, that the blind see, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the dead hear, and the dead are raised. The poor have the gospel preached to them. Next verse. And blessed is he who is not offended because of me. Next one. When the messengers of John had departed, he began to speak to the multitudes concerning John. But what I'm trying to tell you this afternoon, we can stop there, is that Jesus Christ told John that you see me demonstrating heaven on earth. There is no lame in heaven. So wherever I go to, why should God be lame? Lame, get up. There is no death in heaven. There is no dead in heaven. Everyone in heaven is alive and well. There is no sickness in heaven. So the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to do this, and I am doing it. And you are still asking me questions? That's his response to John. So when he came and demonstrated that. And the kingdom of heaven is by the demonstrations and manifestation. It is not only in talk. If you look at Jesus, it's not the kind of person that talks a lot. The only time he talks, like my husband, is when he preaches and he's teaching. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. After that, when you say something, Jesus Christ, when they saw the fig tree, he said, let no fruit come out of you ever. 9 words, and he walks away. He says, be cleansed, and that's it. I will, that's it. Rise up, daughter. He's not a man of talk. He is a man of the demonstration. And that was the message he was sending to John. You see, nobody argues with results. Your life may be, you may be talking and talking and say, I can do this, I can do that. Demonstrate it, and you will see people trooping to you. because no man argues results. Your life will produce results in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your life will produce results in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God certainly wants his children to enjoy the days of heaven and earth. In that book of Deuteronomy chapter 11 verse 21 that we read, he said that so, Deuteronomy chapter 11 verse 21, quick, hallelujah, that your days and the days of your children may be multiplied in the land which the Lord swore to your fathers. That is his desire. He wants us certainly to enjoy days of heaven on the earth. Jesus came to take us back to Eden. The reason I'm bringing Eden into it is because Eden was an extension of heaven on the earth. How did I know that? You see, the land of Eden was a land, but God himself planted the garden. The garden was not Eden. The garden was Eden. And out of the ground, the Lord God made every tree grow that is pleasant to the sight and good for food. The tree of life was also in the midst of the garden. Now, pay attention to that tree of life because we're coming back to it. And the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. The next verse. Now, a river went out of Eden to water the garden. So, the river came and began to water the garden. The Lord himself made a pipeline to water that garden. So, when there is nothing going on around you, don't worry. Your garden is well watered. Your home is preserved. There is prosperity in your home. All you need to do is just believe the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. There was enough in Eden. If there was lack in the city of Eden, there was enough in that garden. Because the Lord himself planted the trees. The trees there, they were for food. The fruits that were coming out of that tree, you can eat them. And do you know what else you can do from the tree? The food that comes out of that tree. Because in the book of Revelation chapter 22, verse 2, Revelation chapter 22, verse 2, it says in the middle of its fruit and on that either side of the river was the tree of life that we talked about, which bore 12 fruits, each tree yielding its fruit every month. The leaves of the tree were for healing of the nations. So they were actually living in perpetual health. They didn't have to watch their sodium intake. They didn't have to watch their sugar intake. They didn't have to care about cholesterol. Because when the tree produced its fruit, it was for healing in their bodies. So whatever was not of God, you know, paradventure, anything came. Because the Bible said that even Lucifer was in that garden as well. So whenever he brought his wahala, the moment they take that tree of life and eat it, there is restoration. And so shall it be for your life in the name of Jesus. There was joy and gladness in the Garden of Eden, which is an extension. I'm trying to paint a picture to you that you can actually go back to Eden from today and enjoy days of heaven on the earth in the name of Jesus. In the book of Isaiah chapter 51 verse 3. Isaiah 51, 3, for the Lord will comfort Zion. He will comfort her of all her waste places. Zion is the church of God. So when they are talking about Zion, it's the present day church. So when they are talking about Zion, they are talking about you. They are talking about Brother Andrew. They are talking about me. They are talking about every believer in the house of God. Hallelujah. So the Lord will comfort Adedayo. He will comfort all her waste places. He will make her wilderness like that of Eden and her desert like the garden of the Lord. Joy. They did not have to look for Versace blazer. They didn't need whatever you call the shoes. I don't remember. You know, they didn't need all that. The glory of the Lord was their covering. And it came forth again when Moses appeared to God. The glory was so much that people could not look at him. Because the glory of God, when it covers you, you just shine bright. Hallelujah. So the glory of God was their covering. When the glory of God is covering you, you make no mistake because you are covered. You understand what I'm saying? You are covered by God. So your mistake is not even noticeable anymore. Hallelujah. When the glory of God covers you, the favor of God is upon you. I say to somebody that shouts the loudest amen this afternoon, that the favor will be upon you. That is why when man sinned, glory was removed and they were aware of their nakedness. Because they lost the glory. That's what happened. They lost the glory and they're like, oops. Eve, darling, we got no clothes. We need to do something real quick. Because they lost the glory. The second thing that Jesus Christ came to do, he came to take us back to Eden, number one. The second thing is he came to teach us how to live this life. We need to know how to live the life according to scripture. The Lord God said to them in the book of Deuteronomy, he said, you do this, you obey my commands. You have to learn. So there are rules in different countries. And that's what Jesus Christ. So if you are going to live like you are living in heaven, on earth, you are going to have to learn the rules of heaven. Hallelujah. Amen. He came to show us that our circumstances is not our problem. Our problem is our ignorance. It is not the devils and the demons that are watching and the witches that are flying at night that is our problem. If I know how to deal with witches, witches will not affect me. If I know that when I'm going to bed, I plead the blood of Jesus over myself, over my house. But if I'm ignorant of that, I beg they will drink blood. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Jesus knew no lack. He demonstrated Edenic living on the earth. Demons respected him. Embarrassment was put to shame. When it was time for Jesus to pay taxes, and there was embarrassment around, he looked at Judas. Judas had spent all the money in the account. And they said, you gotta pay taxes, otherwise you are defying the law. And Jesus is not someone to defy the law. He follows the law. He said, Peter, go to the river. The first one you catch, take money. Pastor always says that Peter was a little dumb because if the first one has money, that means that several of them will have money in their bank. But Brother Peter only took because he was very obedient to the last. But sometimes they say when they send you on errand of a slave, you deliver as a child. He could have taken many more fishes and bring out money. But what I'm saying is that Jesus refused to be embarrassed by the loss of the earth because he was walking in the principles of heaven, principles of miracles. So embarrassment was shame for you. From today on, you will not be embarrassed. Amen. Embarrassment will be shame for your sake. He embarrassed hunger. The Lord Jesus Christ fed 5,000 people with 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. How can somebody do that if he is not under the supply of heaven? Your home is supplied by heaven in the name of Jesus. Demonstrate heaven on earth. In the book of Acts chapter 14 verse 11, now when the people saw what Paul has done, they raised their voices saying in their Laconian language, the gods have come to visit us. Paul demonstrated heaven on earth. After he survived, he got to a village called Malta, and when he was trying to cook something, a snake came and wrapped its tongue around him, and they said, this man has sinned. This man is a demon. The snake has come to get him, and the snake beat him, and he just took the snake on the floor, and nothing happened to him. And when they saw that nothing had happened to him, they began to worship and say, you are God, sir. Hallelujah. Because he demonstrated heaven. No snake, no poison in heaven. Hallelujah. The Bible says that we shall carry snakes in our hands, and they will not hurt us. That is a demonstration of heaven on earth, and it shall be possible in your life in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 6, verse 6, it says, he all your way, to renew them again to repentance, since they crucify again for themselves the Son of God and put him to an open shame. Let's look at the next verse. Am I reading the book? Okay, what I want to talk about is the powers of the age to come. That is the power that we are working right now. The powers of the age to come. We are fast forwarding into that power. And that power is made available for us, and you will get it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Quickly, I want to talk to us about how do we access the days of heaven and earth. I have described to you, I have painted the picture of Eden to you as an extension of heaven on the earth. I have presented Jesus Christ, even as our Lord, the one that we should model our life about and follow after, how he demonstrated heaven on earth. How do we, as the children of God, demonstrate the reality of heaven on earth? The first thing you want to know is who you are. You have to know who you are. If you don't know who you are, you will be anything and you will be everything. Hallelujah. Everybody is lumberjack until they say, no, I am Adedai. You are not lumberjack, I am Adedai. So you need to know who you are. Jesus knew who he was. There are several instances in the scripture. When people ask him and say, who are you? We say, I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. I am the true and faithful one. I am this one. I am the Son of the Most High. He knew who he was. In the book of John chapter 8 verse 25, John 8 verse 25, and they said to him, who are you? And Jesus said to them, just what I have been saying to you from the beginning. That's who I am. Let's look at the next verse. Next verse. I have many things to say to you and judge concerning you, but he who sent me is true, and I speak to the world those things which I have heard from him. He is the one that shines the light to our heart. He begins to declare it. Anywhere he goes, he declares who he is. In Luke chapter 4 verse 12, he says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. You know, he declares what he is supposed to do. Hallelujah. So you need to declare who you are and what you carry. What do you got? As we say in America, what you got? What do you have in you? You need to say it out. You need to say what you have. You need to let the devil hear it. You need to let your ears hear it. You need to let your mind hear it. And you need to let the whole world hear it. I am the child of God. In the book of Ephesians chapter 2 verse 10, it says in the New Living Translation, Ephesians 2:10, New Living Translation, hallelujah, for we are God's masterpieces. I am the masterpiece of God. Designer's original. Yes, there is no to me. Say to yourself, there is no to me.
Yes.
I am the masterpiece.
I am the masterpiece.
And what am I doing? I am created to do the good things. Only good things. No crisis is permitted around my life. You declare that to yourself. You need to know who you are. You need to be born again. I've said that before. You need to have a right standing with God. The book of Romans chapter 8 verse 16. Romans 8, 16. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. You need to realize that you are a child of God. If you are the child of the King of Kings, then no issue should be too difficult for you to handle. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am an heir of God and a joint heir with Jesus. Galatians chapter 4 verse 7, Galatians, therefore you are no longer a slave but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. You know, it doesn't say you are a babe. It doesn't say you are a children. You are a son and a heir. Nobody makes babies heirs. We will get to that in a few minutes. An heir has the power to partake in the inheritance. So the inheritance, we've talked about that in one of our teachings, the inheritance is good health, good life. Where the foot of my, where the sole of my foot has touched, I have taken it, that is my inheritance. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. So immigration has no power, because Jesus Christ did not have to deal with immigration. In fact, Jesus Christ was going all over the places. He didn't have to worry about entry visa. Hallelujah. Because everything, every door opened for him. There are sons. A lot of Christians are babies. You know what babies do? They cry. Baby wants to eat, cry. Baby wants to poop, cry. Baby wants to sleep, cry. A lot of Christians spend most of our lives, we cry. Oh Lord, the door is not open, Lord. Oh, what am I going to do? Open the door, open the door. We cry and cry. And God is expecting us to be sons. Sons declare. Sons take. They assume the responsibility. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Children beg. The Lord has not called us to beg him. He has given us authority to lay hold of our inheritance. But the inheritance has been ratified by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You need to grow to sonship. When you are a son, you don't beg for healing. You don't beg for your progress. You don't beg for victory. You don't beg for the fruit of the womb. You take it. Sons take. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 19. Romans 8, 19. It said, for the earnest expectation of the creation, eagerly, you know, my NIV, I'm with, let's go to my NIV. Hallelujah. I want you to, the creation waits in eager expectation for the sons of God to be revealed. Another version says, for the manifestation of the sons of God. Sons of God manifest. How do you take, how do you go back to Eden? You begin to manifest your sonship. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You need to grow into sonship. We all need to grow into sonship. We don't want to become, to live our lives as children. I was thinking about it, and I said, no wonder. When Bible is talking about the children of Israel, he kept calling them Israel, children. Children. And as long as they were children, they were acting like children. Oh Lord, we want man. When the people were at the tip of Red Sea, they started there. Ah, this is too much. Oh Lord, take us back to Egypt. Lord, you know how children act? Oh mommy, where, are we there yet? It's too far. Praise the Lord. Because he's a child. Children, they start crying, they start asking, Lord, help us. If they were really sons, when they crossed that river, that Red Sea, wasn't that enough for them to know that, oh, Lord is with us? Wait till the next problem. It was now food. They want the cucumbers that was they were eating in Egypt. They want the life that they were living in Egypt because of little hardship. Sons look into hardship and say, I am over you. Children will look at little hardship like this and they will make a mountain out of it. I can't take down my pants. Ah, mama, it's not possible. I really can't take them down. I need to be now. I can't take my pants. It's a big issue for children. But when you become a son, you look at that situation and you say, if God be with me, I will take this mountain down. Those are children. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am a citizen of heaven. I am entitled to the privileges of heaven. You say that to yourself. That is how to access it. You make sure that you make a declaration of who you are. You are an ambassador. An ambassador of Christ is an authorized messenger. That means I have all heaven backing me up.
Yes.
So in this encounter that I am facing, I am not alone by it. This sickness that is trying to get into my body. So whatever I do, you have to be careful what you say. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Search the number two thing, how to access heavens on earth. Search this, to discover who you are. Search to discover who you are. The book of Luke chapter 2 verses 46 to 59. After 3 days, they found him in the temple courts, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. That's Jesus Christ. Everyone who heard him was amazed at his understanding and his answers. You know, this time he was about 12 years old. He was still a child. But the man was searching the scripture, asking questions. How do I get to my sonship? You know, when Jesus Christ was a baby, he could not do anything. When Herod was harassing them, the parents had to carry him. He could not, Jesus, the Son of God, the Most Anointed, he could have gotten up and disappeared and nobody would have. But he had to grow to sonship. When he was a baby, his mom still had to feed him. His father still had to pat him in the back. When he was a child, he began to go into childhood. He began to listen to the word of God. He searched the scriptures. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. His mother said to him, "Son, why have you treated us like this? A mother that left her son and found him 3 days later. That is a mother that I don't know who he is about. Your father and I have been anxiously searching for you." The man was in the temple listening to the word of God, growing into sonship. His mother and his father, they had gone one day. They did not notice that their son was missing. So they found him after 3 days in the temple. Shouldn't they have known that they should look for him in the temple? But to them, he was still a child. The man was growing into sonship. And he said to them, "Why were you searching for me?" he asked. "Didn't you know I had to be in my father's house?" To become a son, to enjoy heaven on the earth, in this time and hour, you have to be in your father's business. You have to search the scripture. Because everything else out there is about death. Out there is killing, is calamity. But those who dwell in their father's house, those who go about their father's business, they are protected from all this. You are protected in the name of Jesus. The book of Revelation chapter 1 verse 6. Search to discover who you are. Revelation chapter 1 verse 6, quick. "And God has made us kings and priests to his God and his Father. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen." The book of 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9. 1 Peter 2 verse 9. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9. Hallelujah. Quick. Who is there? 1 Peter 2 verse 9. "But you are a chosen generation." Amen. Say, "I am a chosen generation."
I am a chosen generation.
A royal priesthood just tells you that you are a king and a priest. That means you have authority as a king. How many people know that when a king speaks, that is it? Hallelujah. And you are a priest. You go into the presence of God, even on behalf of people, to offer sacrifices. Hallelujah. A holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim. The reason that you are set apart is so that you proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous. That is your reason for existence. That means that wherever you go, you would proclaim the praises of him. If praise is not in you, it is impossible for you to proclaim the praises of God. Hallelujah.
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 Don't give up. Labor in the word of God. Labor in the word. Don't quit. Don't give up. Prayerfully engage in searching the scripture. Search the scripture. In the book of Luke chapter 15, the woman that lost a penny. The story of the woman that lost a penny, verse 5. Luke chapter 15, verse 5. Hallelujah. And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders rejoicing. Okay, that's the one that was looking for his sheep. But there was another story of the woman that was looking for her money. The Bible said that she turned on the light. She began to search everywhere. She searched everywhere until she found it. When she found that coin, she now rejoiced in it. Hallelujah. The same thing with you. When you are looking, when the situation is not looking as if it is heaven in your life, search the scripture. Look into the scripture. Look for a scenario. Look for a word that will describe what your situation will be and say that word. Enforce your sonship to enjoy days of heaven on earth. You have to enforce it. What killed Adam, what kicked him out of the Garden of Eden was because he did not enforce the authority that was given unto him. You don't want to go there because it's an issue of man and woman. Hallelujah. But the fact is, he was the one that was given the responsibility and he was the one that messed up. Even though his wife helped him. Hallelujah to mess up. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But you need to enforce your sonship. The number six thing is total obedience to the word. If you look into that Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 22.
Deuteronomy 11, verse 22.
"For if you carefully keep all these commandments, which I command you to do, to love the Lord your God, to walk in all his ways and to hold fast to him." That's all. There is no two ways about it. You have to obey the word of God. Total obedience to the word of God. That's what he's asking you to do. If you are not ready to obey the word of God, you are not ready to live in Eden. If you are not ready to live in heaven on earth, because the man, the Lord, is the one that owns heaven and his laws are the ones that we have to follow. A lot of Christians are not ready to obey the word of God. bit here. You know, let's add a little bit more to it. Let's add a little bit more to it here. Let's put Bible aside. Have you heard that before? No, let's Bible aside. This is reality here. This is, you know, this, those things they are saying in the Bible is somebody's imagination. I heard somebody saying that is somebody's imagination. No! It's not somebody's imagination. Actually, when I was researching this, I found out that Eden exists around Ethiopia. Great to go, Africa. It's God is around Ethiopia. Amen. So it exists until today. So it's not, and they are excavators. Is that right? Excavators. They found some things in there that actually suggested that there was human presence in there. Hallelujah. So it's not a figment of somebody's imagination. If you are confused about the word of God, all you have to do is to go on Wikipedia. You will find it there. You will find the great, you know, researches that people have done. You obey the word of the Lord, fear the Lord, honor him, reverence him, serve him. Hallelujah. The book of Deuteronomy chapter 10, verses 12 to 13. Deuteronomy chapter 10, verses 12 to 13. And now Israel, what does the Lord your God require of you but to fear the Lord of your, the Lord your God, to walk in all his ways and to love him, to serve the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him, honor him, revere him, serve him with all your heart. And you're on your way back to Eden. Hallelujah. You will live your days as if you are living in heaven. In the name of Jesus. Abstain from sin and embrace righteousness. Sin was what made Adam to lose Eden. It was not Satan. It was not Eve. It was sin. Sin of disobedience to the commandments of God. And a lot of Christians live in sin perpetually, and then, you know, you are committing adultery, and you are coming on Sunday and praying. We are not perfect. When we walk, it's not possible for head not to shake. Who told you that? We cannot continue to live in perpetual sin. Sin must be something that we detest. And I was set free when I heard Jesse Duplantis say that you can actually live a sinless life. You can live a life that you don't sin. And I started putting it into practice. I'm not going to lie today. I'm not going to lie. And I tell myself, I won't lie today. I won't lie today. And I began to take that out of my life. Little by little, I stopped lying. If I lie, I confess quickly. And I will go back to God. God forgive me. Some people are supernatural liars. When they tell you it is morning, you go out and check. There will be light outside. It is light. That's how some people are. They don't even, do you know something? I found out also that the person that you lie to, you are afraid of that person. And the Bible says that you should only fear God. So if you are not afraid of, if I lie to you, it's because I want to look good to you. And that is the reason we lie. We don't want somebody to find out our error. And the one that is in heaven that you should be afraid of knows about your error. Yes. You're supposed to fear God only. Yes. Don't try to avoid sin or not avoid sin. Don't let sin take over you. Embrace righteousness, the foundation of all shame, all penury, and all reproach is sin. Righteousness is the way back to living in heaven and on earth. Keep the commandments of God. Keeping the commandments of God makes us strong because our obedience enables God to move with power in our lives. Obedience also keeps the prosperity that we get from hurting us. Hallelujah. If you get prosperity, the Bible says that the prosperity of a fool is his demise. It kills him. But when we are obeying God and God prospers us, just as it says in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18 verse 8, and we go and we are prospering, and the prosperity begins to multiply. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So let's obey God. The key to heaven on earth is to hearken unto God. Listen to God. Search the word of God. What does God say about this situation? What does God say? If whatever situation comes around you, what does the word of God say? No matter the diagnosis they bring, what does the word of God say? You will serve the Lord your God, and he will take sickness and disease away from you. The number of your days, he will fulfill.
Yes.
So which one is sickness there? Which one is disease there? Hallelujah. He sent his word and healed them. Hallelujah. He delivered them from all their diseases. So what is it that is taking you down? But beloved, I wish above all things that you will prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers. That means that I will prosper and will be in good health, and my soul, my body, my spirit is prospering. That is heaven on earth. Hallelujah. And I pray over you this afternoon, you will enjoy it. You will not only hear of it, you will enjoy it in the name of Jesus. Your children will enjoy it. The Bible says in that book of Deuteronomy, he said, talk about it to your children. Don't only murmur it among yourself. Open the word with your children, with your grandchildren. Begin to determine what their life will be like from the scripture. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You search the scripture for the promises of God for your future. And you get hold, you take hold of it. You are going to be great. You will be great. You are a pillar in the house of the Lord. You are an ornament decorating the palaces of God. That is who our children will be. It is in the scripture. Psalm 144. It is there. Our sons shall grow as trees. Hallelujah. Ornaments. Diadems. Great shall be the peace of my children. You need to look at it. If your child is looking somehow, great is your peace. Oh, what? Hallelujah. I'm letting it go now because we have a lot of people. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So shall it be for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your children will rise.
Amen.
They will call you blessed.
Amen.
Just because of the fact that you decide to serve, and honor the Lord your God, to obey Him, the children and the children after you, they will rise up and call you blessed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible says that your walls are salvation, your gates are praise. So shall it be for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There will be no more disaster around your homes in the name of Jesus. There will be no more oppression around you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Rise up with me. Let's make this confession. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say with me, I am on my way back to Eden.
I receive light, I receive revelation, I receive understanding, I prophesy
by the power of the Holy Spirit and by the force of righteousness.